I didn't check the VPN, but hopefully we're okay. Hello, everybody.
Hi.
Let us know if you can hear us and see us okay. We are coming at you from Shenzhen, which is a bit of a change because we are always seem to be out and about, but we have been in Shenzhen for a little while. Hey, what? It looks funny how you're looking now.
Yeah, sorry, I'm just trying to. I'm just trying to get so I can get the comments on the pad so I can read what's going on.
Yeah, I got it now. So, we are in a place called
Huaqiangbei.
Huaqiangbei. Yeah, and that is, to my knowledge, it's one of the world's biggest electronics markets. And it's an incredibly busy place. Right now, it's 6:30. So, we're kind of catching it in rush hour, aren't we?
Well, a lot of people are actually going home from all the wholesale places. The retail places will still be open, but a lot of the wholesale places, they will be closing now because they closed about 5-6 o'clock.
Just going to shout a few people out. I just saw a comment come in, says, I'm behind you two.
Oh.
Well, come and say hello and you can be on the screen.
Yeah. SL, whoever SL is.
Yeah. Emily Martin, that's my sister. Hello, Emily.
Hi, Emily. How you doing?
Where are you? We are in a place called Huaqiangbei, which is an electronics market. I'm going to spin you around, actually, so you can see where we're headed instead of my face. But if you are just coming in, please, please do drop a like on the video because it does help this stream get out much, much faster. And that would be good. So as you can see, there's plenty of people around. There always is in this place.
Yeah, it's quite a happening place at night.
It is.
It's always busy till way after 10 o'clock. Well, saying busy, there's always people about until way after 10.
Where's your mask, boys? Well, we are outside. So I don't really feel too unsafe when I'm outside. The only place people... Everybody wears them now in China is kind of on the metro. That's the only place I see everybody wearing a mask. Shenzhen's pretty safe, you know, it has been for several months now. So I don't feel like I need to be wearing one.
So John259's in from Norwich in England where it's raining.
Well, it was raining here yesterday. It's just come into autumn here, and autumn in Shenzhen is just fantastic in my opinion because it never really rains and it's just kind of bright blue sky and sunny most days, which is nice.
Autumn's a nice time of year in Shenzhen because it's not too hot, you know, it's just cool down enough, but not cold enough that you need to wear a jumper, you know, you can just sort of walk around in your t-shirt, so it's pretty good really.
You know what, today as well is it marks the 40th anniversary of when Shenzhen became a special economic zone, which is kind of cool because 40 years ago this place was just like a little fishing village.
So
and I know a little fact about this Huaqiangbei, right? Huaqiangbei, when it first was put here, people thought, oh yeah, just put an electronics market there, it doesn't really matter. It was on the edge of the city at that point. And little did they know it was going to become like almost the center of Shenzhen. And, you know, it's the, what's it called? The rental prices and things like that are just sky high around this area. It's kind of a...
So we've had Xi Jinping in Shenzhen today.
And who's Xi Jinping for people who don't know?
Who's Xi Jinping? I'm sure everybody knows who Xi Jinping is.
I don't know, maybe.
But he's been here today giving a speech, and there's been a lot of other top officials here as well. A lot of Shenzhen, like the mayor and all the top officials from Shenzhen, and they've been sort of outlining what they're hoping that Shenzhen will be in the coming. Hey, what are these robots here? This looks a bit interesting. We've got some little.
I don't know, that doesn't look too interesting to me, I'm not going to lie. Just some little robots
got a cute little cat face
cat faces
on that
on
one.
This guy seems happy though.
Yeah. He's probably happy because he wants to sell us something. He thought we were a customer maybe.
Yeah, maybe. So as the title of this live stream does say, we are going to run this as kind of question and answers. So please do tell us, you know, ask us anything, and we'll try and answer the comments.
So I want to address something that will probably start going a bit crazy on social media by Western media. So there's been an outbreak of COVID here in China, and it's somewhere between 6 and 12 people that were discovered to be tested positive for COVID-19 in the city of Qingdao. So in order to get on top of this, this just shows you how on top of it they are here. They're going to test the whole population of the city, which is 9 million people. And they've identified that to do that within a week. But it seems they're already maybe in front of the target, because the latest I heard, within the first 2 days, they've tested 5 million people. Can you just get your head around that? 5 million people they've tested in 2 days.
That's a lot of people.
Because I'm sure there'll be conspiracy theories on the internet that people go, oh, it's all flaring up in China again. Well, this just shows you how sort of thorough they are here. They will get a small, they've found a very small amount, like 12 people, yet they're going to test like 9 million.
I know, it's they kind of set the standard pretty high, don't they, in terms of
they absolutely
here.
Do.
Got a comment in from Tom Barrett, which is my brother. Has Lee got any t-shirts without his name on? Ask him for a mate. He does not.
I might have one or two.
Every t-shirt he wears every day has got his name on.
It's kind of strange though, because my age, when I was kind of young, Lee was a big brand in the UK, Lee Jeans, and then it kind of disappeared. China, it seems to be quite a popular brand, so
now you tell
I
us in the comments.
Just partake in some branded stuff.
You tell us in the comments if you think it's cool to wear t-shirts with your name on.
Absolutely, it's cool. Now, there's something a bit odd going on here, Ollie.
What's that?
Because I can see like more than 200 in the stream. I can only see like 60 something likes.
Hold on, let me just try and work the maths out there. Yeah,
that means like 2/3 of the people watching haven't hit that like button, have they?
They have not. Please do change that. It will help the stream get out there. It really does help more than you know. Now, once again, for the people who are just recently joining, we are running kind of a Q&A, I guess, here. So if you have anything you want to ask us or anything like that, please do in the live chat and we will get around to it. So I haven't been to Huaqiangbei for a long time. When I first came to China, this is kind of like a fortnightly trip down to Huaqiangbei, but I haven't been here for ages. I did come here in March when COVID started and was in like full force here in China, and there was no one here. It's actually kind of a interesting video to go and look back on. It will date well. It's on our channel, it's called A City of 13 Million Has Become a Ghost Town. Now if you didn't see that, please do go back and watch it, because it wasn't like this. There wasn't plenty of people walking around. I was walking along here and I was probably one of about five people, which is probably never going to happen for a long, long time again.
Okay, so Kel Wang saying it's 6:40, but it's already dark. Yeah, actually, where we are in China, there's not much difference between summertime and wintertime. It seems to get dark.
About half an hour difference.
Pretty much the same time. And then we've got, how do you tell if you're in a drone no fly zone? Does it show up on the app? It actually does, interestingly. For the next 10 days, drone flying.
Explain what people, what it means.
So, as part of the DJI app, DJI put into their database places where you can't fly your drone, and basically it doesn't let you take off. And that's simply to, so you can't fly like near airports and stuff. But I got a message off DJI the other day, which said that for the next 10 days in Shenzhen, there'll be no drone flying at all. It's all banned across Shenzhen. from the DJI app. So that's because of what's going on here. There's a lot of leaders and very important people here. They've forbidden drone flying within Shenzhen.
I've just walked past that music because it will get us demonetized off YouTube. So hopefully that's all good.
Oh, it's one of those DJI little robots.
I know, I was just about to say. I just want to thank...
This is so cool.
I just want to thank Simon NG for that super chat there.
Appreciate that, Simon.
Yo, buddies, Shenzhen is awesome. It is. It is a cool city. I don't know who's controlling this, but someone's controlling this... this little
seems
robot
to be here. Some sort of tech event going on here. Rambo!
I don't know who was controlling that. I can't see anybody.
Don't push me!
What?
Rambo. Don't push me!
No one's going to know what you're on about.
Of course they are!
You're too old, mate. That's what
people,
it is.
People my age will know.
We've got 260.
Yeah, RoboMaster awesome. S1, that's absolutely correct.
We've got 262 in here. Please do hit that share button and share this with your friends if you do think they would find this huge electronics market
some
interesting.
Some cool kids outfits there, look.
Hello, Caliber Wings. Good to see you in here, my man.
Oh, he was thinking of coming down and meeting us, but he's got a cold. But I said we'd tie up with him before we go off to Beijing.
Tim says, showing your age, Lee.
Yeah.
You are quite old, aren't you, mate?
I am, yeah. I'm getting a bit old.
Yeah, I think this must have been quite busy throughout the day because a few of these little stores are shutting down. But I did see like a stage over there with some girls dressed up in like kind of cosplay outfits and stuff. So we'll see if they're still there. Let's see. There's one here. We've got kind of a photo shoot going on. Do you wouldn't mind one extra camera on her, I don't guess?
Oh, she might be getting ready for a photo shoot or some live streaming.
No, they're doing it right now. They're doing a photo shoot.
He's taking
photos of her. Someone said, who's here learning English? That's kind of cool. I think it's cool that people can use our stuff as a learning resource. It's not something I foresaw before we made videos, but that's kind of cool. The wind's picking up a bit. I do hope it's not going to rain.
So get your questions in. It is a Q&A session, so get your questions in and we'll do our best to answer them.
Elizabeth G says, trust Ollie. Yeah, you might be right. ZY says, Huaqiangbei. Yeah, this is Huaqiangbei. And Charles. Yeah, we're in Huaqiangbei if you're just joining in right now. And if you've been to Shenzhen, I'm sure you know this place. It's a kind of iconic in this city. Another super chat has flown in by Anthony Chan. Thank you very much for that super sticker. He gives us a fist bump, so a fist bump to you too.
Good stuff.
Where's that stage gone?
I don't know what's going on there. A bit of strobe going on.
Hold on, we've come to the opposite side. Stage is at that side. Okay, let's walk back.
We can go this way.
Let's have a look.
Yeah.
No, I meant like at the other end.
Oh.
They kind of have...
So what? Something must be giving. Oh, what's going on here?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, we are at the stage.
What's going on here?
Yeah, we are at the stage. I was getting mixed up.
I can Hold see on. Some girls in Hanfu.
In Huaqiangbei, they put pianos around just for random people to come and play, which is kind of cool. Look, this is where we are. You see it written there, Huaqiangbei. Play me, I'm yours. I love Huaqiangbei. Look at that. I'd like to learn how to play the piano. Bram Killapong says, is the new Huawei P40 Mate Pro already sold there?
No, it comes out on the 22nd, I believe. It's an online launch event. We're going to be launching on the 22nd of October.
So there's loads of people here queuing for something. I'm not sure what they are queuing for. I kind of want to find out. So look, we've got kind of people dressed up in like cosplay stuff. She's got purple hair. People are wearing all sorts of interesting clothes. Let's have a look what's going on. Emily, are they still routinely testing the general public if they have symptoms of COVID? Yeah, they are. Yeah, there's just been a small outbreak in
Qingdao,
and they're testing the whole city of 9 million in a few days. So they're kind of hot on it here.
There's some going on in here, by the way.
Look at this. This is so China. This is so China. It's just a booth.
So you can see they're live streaming.
We're both live streaming. This is live streamception. Look, so they're on there doing whatever they're doing. I don't really know what they're doing, to be honest.
They'll be selling stuff, probably.
Yeah, it looks like it, because they've got some products in front of them.
So just to let you know, live streaming for selling stuff here is massive. There's literally live streamers who sell millions of yuan's worth of products in, like, hours.
Yeah, we were talking to that one person who was selling cars, wasn't it? And they sold, like, a bunch of cars on a live stream.
Oh, there's people who've sold, like, you know, billions of yuan's worth of stuff in a year. I was reading about a girl yesterday.
Caliber Wings, thank you so much for that generous super chat. For the
Hi.
Thank you so much for the generous super chat. For the great videos the father and son team have been putting out at Huawei conference and tech conventions and more. Yeah, live streaming is tomorrow now. Yeah, you're absolutely right. I think they're mentioning us on the live stream. Thank you very much for that, Caliber Wings.
This is a very, like, interesting dress here, Ollie. Look at this. She looks
good.
Ming Dynasty. It looks very, very beautiful, doesn't it, that? This is Ming Dynasty traditional dress. It's really cool. Getting some photos there.
Psych asks, ever plan to do the same, live streaming or selling for the UK audience? I think it's kind of, it would be ahead of its time at this point.
Shall we walk that down that way?
It'd be ahead of its time, I think, wouldn't it, at this point?
Yeah.
Live streaming or selling in the UK, it wouldn't, I don't see it being as popular. Maybe it'll get to that point.
Here it's huge, you know, it really is big, big business here.
Look at that. I have no idea what's going on here. Maybe someone who's watching can speak Chinese and help us out what this actually is. Or read this.
It's somebody in traditional dress.
Donna, what event is going on? I'm not too sure.
Let's move this way a bit.
We're gonna be moving. Oh, she's got plenty of people taking photos. Have a look. She's like a public model right now. It's a gaming festival, apparently. Video game festival. Huh.
Okay. There's some interesting booths. This looks... I don't know what's going on here. Let's have a look at this.
It's got neon lights.
A lot of lights going on.
That's what pulls you in. Leo Chung. I also want to visit the event. I'm just 10 kilometres away, but in the south.
These are massages, these are.
It'll take me 14 days to get there. Leo Chung, I can see that member icon next to your name as well. So thank you so much for becoming a member. And that is a good segue. If you do want to become a member, you can click the join button below the video and you will get some funny face emojis that we made and some extra perks over there. So if you do want to become a member, you're a legend.
Support us, that's really good. It just helps us. You know, some of the things, you know, a lot of things we actually pay for out of our own pockets, destinations we go. Not everywhere, but sometimes we have to. And it really helps us to go to places and bring content, you know. So that's very much appreciated for those who are members.
Are you from the US, says Anthony. No, we're both from the UK. Psych says, how about visit a local spa? I mean, that's not really what I had in mind for this live stream, but we're back. If we do go for a second, do bear with us because we are using a VPN. I can just see some lads skateboarding here, so I'm going to see if they can do some cool tricks for us. Let's see if he's going to do some of them. I think. Go on, mate, do a trick. Go on. Oi. Oh, unlucky man. Maybe next time. It's better than I can do anyway. The little girl.
Whereabouts in the
Hello.
UK? I'm from the Midlands, actually. I grew up in an area called the Black Country, just outside of Birmingham.
And I grew up in Worcestershire,
yeah.
If you know where that is. When people ask in China, they always say, which city did you come from? Which city do you live in? And I always have to kind of make it up, like just the closest one, because I just lived in a very rural place and nobody knows it. Do you have a TikTok account, says Hey Huang. We don't have a TikTok account. We do have a Douyin account, which is TikTok in China. And if you want to know what it is, it's Barrett Kanzhonghua. So you can check it out. We've got a few things over there. We're trying to get a bit more into it.
I'll just give a shout out to a few people. We got Lily Lucy, we got Liu Dou, we got Maria De Santos, Sabrina Chan, Kel Wang, Kay Kek, Caliber Wings, and no one.
And no one.
And no one.
Now people are typing some Chinese. If you do want me to be able to read them, I do apologize. Please do try to put it in English. My Chinese is not good enough, but I'm trying. Tamming all VPN though. Yeah, we're using a VPN. Hey. Oh.
Kao Wang, he lives in Oxford and London. He's happy that he's come across our channel. Snarky guys in the house.
It's actually not as busy here as I thought it would be.
Any news about Mate 40 Pro? Yeah, Mate 40 Pro is launching on the 22nd of October via an online event here.
Arthur Lee, you guys are doing very well showing the real China to the world. I mean, we will say this again, you know, that's kind of what we're trying to do, because there's so much outside of China just twisting the facts. You know, there's not that many people on the ground here giving an objective view of what the situation's like. So hopefully we can, you know, push it in that direction and make people understand China a little bit, you know?
Yeah, I mean, from a point of view of COVID, it's pretty much completely under control here now. As we said earlier, there's been a small outbreak in Qingdao. They discovered it was either 9 or 12 people, and they've basically tested in the whole city of 9 million for that small outbreak. So it just shows you how on top of it they are here. And that's why life is pretty much back to normal here. You know, we don't have to wear a mask. Actually, in Shenzhen, it seems to be still a lot of people wear masks, more so than most other cities we've been to.
From my experience, everywhere I've been in China in the past 6 months, Shenzhen is still, you know, the strictest. Do you reckon?
I think so, yeah.
Like the more people than anywhere else here are wearing masks.
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's the strictest, but there's still more people wearing masks, even many more than Shanghai, which is kind of interesting.
Yeah, seem to be quite relaxed there. I just want to give a shout out to... Let me go back up.
So. I'll find it. London calling. Super sticker. We really appreciate
coming
that.
Coming in with the Superman super sticker. Appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Yeah, somebody's snarky. Only wear a mask on the metro here in Shanghai. Everywhere else, not necessary. That's kind of a bit like here. You will get on the metro and literally everybody wears a mask. Or in some shopping centres or closed places, you know, where you're close together. But the metro is one of them. In fact, I don't think it's compulsory.
No, it is. I was asleep earlier on the metro coming here, and I had my mask like so my nose is showing, and someone tapped me on the leg. The security guard on the metro tapped me on the leg and was like, "Oi, wear it properly." I was like, "Okay, sorry." So I should have been wearing it properly anyway, to be honest. So, what's going on here? Oh, I saw this on the way up. People are queuing.
It's a cosmetics thing, isn't it? Yves Saint Laurent.
you can bet your bottom dollar, if something is free in China, people are going to be taking it. Isn't that right?
Absolutely. Obviously,
people go to great lengths here to get a discount, don't they? Or get something small for
and
free.
And I tell you what, girls and women here love their branded cosmetics.
Oh, yeah.
The big brands, the Chanel's, the Yves Saint Laurent's, the Gucci's, love it here.
They absolutely love the branded cosmetics here. They make a killing.
And skincare is another massive thing here, like, huge.
Just trying to read some comments that are coming in here.
I just want to bring something up, because I'm noticing we've got a lot of people in from Australia. And something interesting, it seems to me Australia's kind of aligned themselves a little bit with the US, with their foreign policy on China. And that seems to be having some kind of big repercussions now for Australia. It seems as though China are going to start sourcing their coal from somewhere else. They've actually diverted some massive bulk cargo ships of coal, because apparently power stations in China have been told to stop using Australian coal. And I was reading today, and I think I put it out on Twitter, China have just signed a massive deal with Brazil to buy iron ore. And iron ore is pretty much Australia's biggest export to China. So I think, and there's a number of people who study sort of foreign policy who are suggesting that the Australian Prime Minister's gone a bit far in his sort of rhetoric against China. I just wanted to know what any Australians in the comments think about that.
Let's see.
Oh, Snapdragon Lee, what is your current business? Our current business is making content for YouTube. We are pretty much full-time content creators.
Well, not pretty much. We are absolutely full-time content creators. Which is kind of a dream come true, to be honest. I never thought I'd be calling myself a full-time content creator 18 months ago. So, just again, a massive thank you to all of you who have made that possible, honestly, because it's kind of a blessing.
No, Snapdragon, I'm not doing any other business at the moment apart from
making
content.
Douyin and YouTube.
Yeah, so just so YouTubers know what they are, Toutiao and Bilibili are kind of, they're like YouTube platforms, but they're Chinese versions. And we launched on them about 4 months ago now. We're doing, they're growing. So if there's any Chinese out there that see us on Bilibili or Toutiao, give us a shout.
I had a thought then, but it was about Bilibili and Toutiao. So that's just two of many, many popular video platforms here in China, which is kind of a foreign thing to us in the West and a lot of other countries as well, where YouTube is just the absolute dominant, unstoppable force in terms of video platforms. We don't really have any other viable option. Whereas here, there's even some people who have not heard of these huge video platforms. Because just to name a few, they've got ITE, they've got Toutiao, they've got Bilibili, they've got Weibo, they've got loads of video platforms, which is really good for creators, because they can put their videos in front of lots of different audiences, which is kind of cool. Snapdragon asks, what is the revenue distribution across your Douyin?
Actually, there's no revenue model on Douyin until you've got a huge amount of subscribers, and it's based on tying up deals with companies to advertise product.
It's very different.
So it's very, very different. It's not easy to make revenue from Douyin. Toutiao and Bilibili are kind of similar models to YouTube.
Where they play ads, right, across your videos.
Well, they don't actually play them in the videos on those platforms. They put them on your kind of channel page.
Oh, right.
But the revenue is far lower than YouTube. But YouTube are a little bit greedy. They do take quite a big cut because they are, you know, they literally have no competition.
They have no competition. It goes
so
back
they can
to
pretty much
saying,
do
yeah.
what they want, you know.
Yeah. But then again, it does provide us to be able to work on it full time. So I have no complaints. I mean, Tian Li. Sorry, changing the subject.
I just want to finish. I just want to say, you know, a lot of what we do get and that enables us to do what we do is from the support of you guys on Patreon, becoming a member. You know, people support us on WeChat, buy us a coffee. So that's why we do push those, because, you know, as creators, putting videos up on YouTube is not a 5-minute job. You know, there's a lot of work behind the scenes. There's two of us, and to get 3 videos a week out, we probably work in excess of 40 to 50 hours a week.
Yeah,
and that's
for sure.
Without the traveling and you know, when we're actually traveling, it becomes really difficult to do that, because, you know, we're on the go from sometimes 6-7 o'clock in the morning till 9-10 o'clock at night.
And saying that, yeah, it's a lot, but I love it. Yeah, I absolutely love it.
We're not moaning, but it's just a case of, I think there's people out there who think, you know, shooting a video and putting it up is like an hour's work, because we get a lot of people in the comments thinking that a video that goes up in the afternoon, we've actually shot it in the morning.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's not the case at all.
Tian Li Wang says, Xi'an is a great place if you're into Chinese history. I've been to Xi'an, and yeah, it is a very historical place for sure. It's got a very nice, very authentic Chinese feel. The one thing that I took away from there though was the food was like my favorite in China. Absolutely, they have a lot of bready things. They've got the famous rojiamo that comes from there, which is kind of called the Chinese hamburger. They eat a lot of like barbecued lamb and things like that. So for a Westerner's palate, I think Xi'an is kind of up there in terms of the food.
Yeah, Snarky Guys just mentioned he had a laptop fixed in a building just where we are. I must say, literally here in this area, if you have anything wrong with your phone, generally you can find somewhere that'll fix it. Should you go and sit down for 5 minutes?
Yeah, all right. Now let's go up to the top of one of those things.
That'd be quite cool.
Leo Chung says it would be great to have 5G equipment for streaming. Now we are actually using a 5G device, however, the problem is because we are going through a VPN, which we do have to in China. you love getting it out, don't you? It's gonna show you now.
Excuse me, you love getting it out. So this is the 5G device.
Every time
we use.
There we go.
So you could, I don't know whether you'll be able to see the screen, but there you go, look.
So we are using one, it's just the fact that we've got a
It's always the VPN that slows it down a little bit, unfortunately. So we're going to go to the top of this. This right in front of us, all blue LED, is the Huaqiangbei Plaza Hotel. So if you ever come here, that's a really great hotel to stop at. It's very, very reasonably priced, but it is a really nice hotel.
Oh, my legs are hurting already coming up here. Tang Angel from Hong Kong. Hi, hope China will continue to be strong in the future. Thank you for coming. We appreciate you being here. Caliber Wings, you have luck in coffee around somewhere. We've got two, actually. I was just saying to Dad, that it was kind of funny. They've got one like, I think it's here, and then they've got one here too, right next door. So they must be kind of busy. And they've opened up two stores right next to each other.
So Rashma Chowdhury has asked, which city is it? It's Shenzhen.
Yes, this is Shenzhen. If you type in Shenzhen on Google or whatever, you're gonna find quite a lot of pictures around this place, because this is a very kind of iconic place here in Shenzhen. I did a time lapse off one of these before. It's actually, if you remember, now let us know if you remember that time lapse as an intro to our videos, because if you do, then you've been around for some time. So that would be kind of cool. You remember the one I'm on about, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
As the intro to the thing. Tianliwang, Terracotta Warriors is also in Xi'an. I have visited there. That is a very, very cool place to see. If a lot of tourists who are coming to China, they'll kind of do like a bit of a Beijing Xi'an route and do the Great Wall of China and the Terracotta Warriors. That's very popular.
So, Shalmarahman, are there any mosques in Shenzhen? I am not aware of any mosques in Shenzhen because there's not a large Muslim population in Shenzhen, to be honest. But if you go up to Guangzhou, which is somewhere where I used to live, there are quite a few mosques in Guangzhou. And I think China has a large amount of mosques sort of countrywide. It's at least one of the countries with more mosques than pretty much anywhere else, to be honest.
Polly Zhang says, where are you now? For anybody who has recently joined, we're in Huaqiangbei, which is one of the world's biggest electronics markets. And it's based here in the center of the city.
So Snapdragon's asking, what do you think about Huawei selling its mobile phone division? Well, I actually made a tweet about this today. They're not actually selling all of their mobile division. They have two brands of phone Huawei does. So they have the main brand, which is the Huawei brand. And then they have a sub-brand called Honor. And that the sub-brand Honor is the lower-end brand. That's what they're selling off, and it looks like they might be selling it to their distributor. It said they might raise about $3.5 billion from that.
Mark Francis says, I have used a DJI Osmo Pocket, so what do you think? We both used to have one and we lost them both over the years. But it was a great camera, a great little camera. Obviously, it's a little bit too small because we both lost them. But no, it was very versatile, good little camera. Hoping they bring out a second one.
I'm sure they will.
In the distant future.
Okay, so an interesting from Polly Jang. Will you buy an iPhone 12? Not a chance. My feelings about Apple is they've got very complacent, and for what they are, they're well overpriced. I mean, you look at the price of this new iPhone 12 and the top of the range one is $1,400. $1,400. You know, you can come and buy a Chinese brand as Xiaomi or Huawei or Oppo or Vivo at like half that price, and the specs are better a lot of the time. It seems to me Apple just do these very slight sort of improvements, but they're not really bringing. I mean, I don't know if it's Oppo or Vivo, but they've just bought out, or they're about to bring out a phone with a built-in mechanical gimbal, get ultra-stable video, you know. And to my mind, it's the Chinese brands that are pushing the envelope with technology, and I think Apple have become a follower rather than a leader. I mean, the Huawei situation is very interesting. Now they've been cut off from manufacturing their silicon. I mean, Huawei have no problem designing silicon. You know, company High Silicon were really at the cutting edge of designing chips. But unfortunately, they've got problems getting them manufactured now because of all the US sanctions. So it'd be interesting to see what happens there.
I just want to mention this one. Hi Barrett, how much did the CCP pay you for your propaganda? I'm still waiting for the check.
Oh, they paid us last month. I think it was about $25,000, wasn't it, we got last month, something like that. Yeah, it's so funny. It's kind of funny because anything that is positive out of the West is news, but anything that's positive out of China is propaganda.
Hey, we can't possibly be having any fun in this oppressive regime.
Because China's just terrible.
Because that would challenge people's narrative, long life narrative of the country.
Right, yeah.
That just can't be happening.
I mean, I suggest whoever has made that comment, you come and spend a little bit of time in China and you'll see for yourself, you know.
It certainly changed my mind before I came here. I thought very different, very, very different. So it's taught me the lesson of never judge a country before I've been there. And that's why I won't judge North Korea. Like, I know it's, to my knowledge, it's an oppressive regime and, you know, whatever, but I would like to visit, as you can, if you go on a guided tour, I'd like to visit and see it for myself and see, you know, how different it is to what I think.
Sharma Rahman asked another question. Are there any halal supermarkets in China? There are. I've not seen any in Shenzhen, but that's because I haven't been to look for them, but I'm sure they're. But I know in there's a huge Muslim population. I saw many supermarkets like that in Guangzhou, and there's quite a lot of halal restaurants there as well, you know, so there's no problem if you are coming here. I'm sure they're in Shenzhen as well. It's just that I haven't ever looked for them in Shenzhen. But there's a much bigger Muslim population in Guangzhou than I know about in Shenzhen.
Simon NG, Cuba is an awesome place as well. I've been there. See, these places I just have no concept of. I'd love to visit. Robert Fraser, I've been to China 5 times. I love it. There are a lot of Christian churches also. I've seen a couple of Christian churches in Shenzhen.
Again, Snapdragon SMIC, do you think they will be able to manufacture 10? I believe they were doing some sort of test manufacturing at 10. But I think they were buying some machines from the Dutch company, those litho machines, and I believe that has been blocked by America. And it also seems now America are going to start sanctioning SMIC as well, which is a shame. But I'm sure China over the next few years will develop the capability of chip foundries. I think there's probably a lot of sort of things going on behind the scenes that are not sort of public knowledge. So I think it'll be interesting the next few years to see what happens.
Jaden Karim, how would you differentiate life between the UK and China? Now that is a very big question to ask, as in, sorry, there's a lot to cover there, but to wrap it up in a couple of points. It's, for me, it's much more enjoyable here. It's very busy, however I do like that. I can be much more focused on work because there's a lot of other people who are busy around doing, you know, career related things, so I can definitely be more motivated here. Another thing is the weather makes a big difference because we can go out in the evenings, which I do really enjoy doing, you know, sitting with friends at 10 p.m. and eating. Kind of weird. Did we lose anyone? No, we're back. Not sure what happened there. I'll carry on answering your question anyway. Yeah, because I can eat out here for relatively cheap, which is nice, and have a few beers and sit outside with locals. And yeah, it's just, I prefer it because it's different. I'm not going to say that living in China would be for everyone. There are, you know, people I've met who really don't like it here. But for me, and I think for you, we like it here a lot.
Yeah, so. I think for me, one of the big advantages of living here is the cost of living is way lower here. So you can do a lot more. Like if you just consider a train, I don't know, from Birmingham to London, the cost of a ticket for a similar journey here would probably be less than a quarter. So
and on a three times faster train.
So travel is much more accessible.
Yeah, definitely.
Way more accessible. So to be able to move around and do things is much easier. And things like electricity and gas are way cheaper here than in the UK.
Yeah, I wouldn't dream of living by myself in the UK. I literally wouldn't be able to do it. But here, it's possible. Even in arguably the most futuristic city in the world, you know, it's one of the most expensive cities in China, and I can still, you know, quite comfortably afford to live alone. Whereas that just would not be the case if I was still in England at all.
Yeah, it's
so that's kind of nice.
Yeah, the cost of living is a lot lower here. Like rents are way cheaper, and you can get, you know, if you don't want to live in the most swankiest of places, you can get rent at a really low rate. Mm. And the apartment ain't going to be your sort of top-end apartment, but they're still okay. And, you know,
One thing that's really different here as well is, I know there's a Chinese saying for it, I can't remember what it is now, but you can live in these cities, you can live as lavishly and as most luxurious as you want, or you can live as frugal as you want, and both are possible in the same area. So I've had times where, especially when I first came to China, I had very little money around, so I was literally eating really cheap every day, and I was able to eat three meals a day for like 50 yuan, which is what, like £5. So you can do that even in this, you know, metropolis of a city, which is cool.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting that you can get food here from, you know, a dollar or two for a meal up to hundreds of dollars for a meal, isn't it?
Yeah.
And massive amounts in between, you know. There's absolutely a massive range of food you can get. Somebody said they'd like to live in China, but they can't speak Chinese well. Ollie's Chinese is getting pretty good. Mine's terrible. But, you know, I've spent about 8 years here in the last 12, and it's not affecting me living here. You know, there's you can always get things done, whether that be using Google Translate. There's in a lot of the cities, to like official places, there's always somebody who can probably speak enough English to help you.
For sure.
You,
I mean,
you
know? it does definitely make things a little bit easier if you can speak the language. And I'm learning, I can't speak fluently, but it does definitely make things a bit easier. But you can easily come and live here without speaking Chinese, if that's your question.
Yeah, it is a pedestrian area. Somebody's looking into pedestrian, yeah. This was pedestrianized. I can't remember how many years back now. So somebody from Shenzhen in the comments, it hasn't always, you can caliber wings, you can survive without Mandarin.
Fat KY, sorry to cut you off. Fat KY says, hit that like button. I like your spirit, my man. Thank you very much. Please do hit that like button. Alex says, is Lee Ollie's dad? I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think I am, yeah.
Yeah, he's my dad. We do this YouTube thing together. Oh, I just saw something about Beijing. Yeah, so I just want to just tell everybody, we are going to Beijing for the first time, for both of us, in about 2 weeks' time. It's going to be I'm pretty certain that it's going to be the biggest YouTube meetup in China ever, right? There's like 12 YouTubers. I think Alex Absolute is going, Daniel Dunbrill is going, Guelo 60 is going, yeah. Some other people are going.
The Mexican guys who do their Chinese, yeah. Spanish, Mexicanos or something like that.
Yeah, they're going as well. And we're all going to be kicking it in Beijing, doing some stuff together.
We might also meet up with Nico while we're there, because she's from Beijing, so we might do that. But
well, she's not from Beijing.
No, she lives in Beijing, yeah. She's not from Beijing. She's originally from the UK, but... but yeah, we're going to meet up with some fellow Brit YouTubers, which will be interesting. Because, you know, British share a sense of humour that most other people don't get. So should we walk that down? And
Steak says Mr. Xi Jinping is in Shenzhen. Go and meet him.
That's right.
Yeah, I think we might see him walking along here.
Yeah. We saw Li Keqiang in Shanghai getting himself a bubble tea, didn't we?
Well, we didn't see him because there were so many people around.
Yeah, yeah.
But he was there.
We have been in contact with Nathan Rich. We saw him at the Huawei event, and we're not planning to do a collaboration with him, but we have seen him. Really nice guy. He was at the same Huawei event that we went to in Shanghai a couple of weeks ago. You may have saw a few seconds clip at the end of one of our videos of him.
Um, SC Blue says, try Hangzhou and Suzhou next time. I've never been to either of those cities, but we may be, maybe, not sure, we may be going to Suzhou in the not so distant future. Bob King, Ollie, do you teach in a school? No, I do not. This is my full-time job, which is kind of cool to say that. Leo, do you count Guelo 60's wife in Beijing trip? He said that he won't go anywhere without Wei Fong. What a good husband.
Wei Fong is going, I believe.
They're joined at the hip, those two, which is cool. So we'll meet his wife as well.
We'll have a walk down here.
From my experience, the locals in Beijing are very friendly. That goes against what I've heard, actually. I've spoke to quite a few people and said that I'm going to Beijing soon, and they actually said quite the opposite. So I guess I'll have to make my own judgment when I'm there.
Yeah, somebody's asking us to go to the Segcom building. It's actually closed now. Most of the wholesale buildings close at sort of about 6 o'clock. It's just generally all the retail places that are still open now. So just over here, there's a place called Coco. This is something that's really massively popular in China. It's kind of a drink store, but they're literally everywhere, and they're always doing business, and they do all kind of fruit drinks and bubble teas and stuff like that. You can see this kind of stuff. It's super popular here in China.
Now, Angela Fuego has asked a good question. She says, a question for Ollie. How has the dynamic of your relationship with you and your dad changed since moving to China? Well, I didn't live with you since I was about 10 years old. So coming to China, I came to live with dad. And of course it changed, because before he was living here, so I never really saw him. And now we're kind of like business partners slash mates slash father and son. Would you say that's a...
Yeah, that's fair. We have our differences, but we always resolve them in the end, don't we?
Of course. I think, you know, I even went traveling with my best friend, and me and him have never had an argument previously. But when you're spending that much time with someone, you always have your differences with them. So that's just life. That's just life, you know? It's cool. I would rather be doing this with you than someone else, I guess.
Yeah.
So we've got 435 people in here now. That's pretty cool.
That's a new tea place. I've not seen that before. Yacht tea.
There's so many of these tea places. They're so popular.
This kind of, you see this here, right? This is what bubble tea is. And it is absolutely massive in China. There's bubble tea shops everywhere. I'm not keen on the bubble tea, but I like the milk ones. My favourite, I've just discovered this new one at Haiti, and it's absolutely delicious. I'm sure it's full of calories, though. Yeah, everybody hit that like button. Really appreciate that.
Yogurt Cinder, I'm sorry if I'm butchering your name, which I probably am. Over there is a fish restaurant. You must go there for dinner. It's very good. That is probably the one that we made a video at over a year ago.
Is it the seafood restaurant?
Yeah, I think that must be the one he's on about.
Because if it is, it's a really good, lovely restaurant.
We made a video on that. It was one of the first videos on our channel. Maybe, you know, we had a few before that one. And that's a really old one. And we've gained a lot of subscribers since then. So probably most of you have never seen it. So go back and see what the early Barrett videos were like, because I can assure you they were very, very different to now.
Restaurants here, a lot of wine going on in that one by the looks of it.
Let's start wrapping this up now. We've been
somebody recognizes us.
I think she's a bit shy.
Yeah.
She said she saw that we went to Chongqing.
Ah.
She's right.
So it was 7-Eleven here, loads of 7-Elevens all over the place, full of snacks, drinks, stuff.
That might be the first super chat I've ever seen in Japanese yen, I think it is.
Cool. So
thank, Jimin, thank you so much. It will be great if you can have a YouTube live with friends in Beijing. Nico, other guys and the Mexicans, they are really interested.
Yeah, we might have a few things planned in Beijing. It's a little bit early yet, but we will be announcing sort of stuff that we've got going on in Beijing. And yeah, so there'll be quite a lot going on there. We're actually going for the two with the others, which is 7 days, but we're planning on staying over a little bit longer, me and Ollie, to do a few more things while we're there. So might have some announcements on Beijing in the coming weeks, so keep them peeled.
Let's start wrapping this up now. We've been going for almost 50 minutes.
Oh, I think we've got to get over that 500 in the stream before we do that. So hit that like button, guys, because there's only 329 likes and 463 in the stream. Is there going to be a shirt? Is there going to be a shirt Nathan Rich video after the cliffhanger? We haven't got a Nathan Rich video. To be honest, I don't think he's the kind of guy that is into collaborations. He's kind of his own man, isn't he?
Yeah, he's doing his own thing, and he's just, you know, fair enough. Just seems like he's doing his own thing, and he's got his own style, which is cool. But it was nice to see him and touch base with him.
Yeah.
Jerry's in here. Hello, mate.
Hiya, Jerry.
And lots of beer emojis. I like the look of that.
Hey, this is pretty cool here. Look at this.
Someone's asked a few times, where is this place? Is it Chongqing? No, we're in Shenzhen, which is where we live. This is about 45 minutes away from where we live, and it's an electronics market, one of the biggest electronics markets in the world, called Huaqiangbei. Now, I'm going to announce it again. We have recently fired up the membership on our channel, right? So if you see down below, you can see a join button, right? Right now it's white, but if you click it and join, it'll be blue. Now that's pretty exciting, and you'll get sort of some funny face emojis of you pulling some funny faces.
Yeah.
And yeah, a bunch of different perks, and you'll be supporting the Barrett channel and our content. So if you do wish to do that, thank you so much. You are a legend.
Just explain how we use the donations that we get on.
So we use donation money. Most of it goes back into the channel to fund equipment and fund trips that we go on. And we do also use this money to live on as well, because this is both of our full-time jobs.
Thank you very much, Gary Lung. We appreciate that.
If you're wondering why I'm looking at this, I'm looking at comments, so yeah, I'm not so being anti-social.
He's using our Huawei pad to have a look at the comments. Well, I've got some nice flowers
sends a super
going
sticker.
On here.
Gary Lung sends a super sticker. Thank you very much for that, my man.
Appreciate that. No, it's not Chongqing, it's Shenzhen.
We're about to go over that owl box, so I don't want to let it go over that.
Okay.
You know what I mean. Thank you everybody who has decided to... Oh, just before, thank you so much for that. I can't see it on here, Fat KY.
Yeah, thank you.
I want to read it. Hold on, stop a sec. Thanks guys for your work, very much appreciated. You are very welcome. Thank you for the super chat and for coming to join us this evening.
Fundy Williams.
Fundy Williams, thank you. Well done guys. Thank you very much. We'll be wrapping this up now here from Huaqiangbei. Thank you all for joining and
thank you, Trevor. Ollie will be getting a phone with the new Huawei Oppon, Harmony 2.
Nice one, man. Thank you very much. Right, we'll be wrapping this up. Thank you all for joining us in Huaqiangbei. Please do see our next video out that's coming out tomorrow, and we will see you next time. Take care for now.
So tomorrow's video is pretty impressive, so take a look.
All right, see you later.